Not so long ago, in the illustrious rabbinic elite of Hungary, one man would undergo a shift so transformative that he would forsake all his former political affiliations in favour of the Zionist cause. Yisachar Shlomo Teichtal was born in 1885 into a family with strong Hasidic connections, his grandfather being a student of the Rebbe of Sanz. He also studied with the Belzer Rebbe and the Munkacher Rebbe, with whom he was especially close. By the age of 22, he had received semicha from no fewer than three different rabbanim. When Rav Teichtal was 19, he married Friedel Ginz, a descendant of Rabbi Akiva Eger, and whose father was a student of the Maharam Shik, but she tragically died shortly after. Teichtal was married again to Nechama Friedman, whose grandfather was a disciple of Chatam Sofer. Also at 19, Teichtal began writing his Chiddushim, or novel ideas, and by the age of 25, he was already receiving questions on all areas of Jewish law. In 1921, he was appointed rabbi of Piesh Tiani, where he would remain for 2 decades until the Holocaust. Piesh Tiani, famous for its natural hot springs, was frequented by many dignitaries and Torah scholars, with whom Teichtal met and discussed matters of contemporary Jewish law. At this time, Rav Teichtal espoused the opinion almost ubiquitous among the Haredi world that Zionism was a terrible plague upon the earth, whose endeavours are the work of Satan, and whose proponents are wicked sinners. Writing in the Munkach newspaper Yiddish Zeitung, which regularly critiqued not only the religious Zionist movement but even the ultra-Orthodox Agudat Yisrael, Rav Teichtal penned an extreme rejection of any efforts to settle or develop the land of Israel. In discussion of the words V'nochal m'periyah v'nesba m'tuvah, may we eat of the land of Israel's fruit and be satisfied from its goodness in the bracha of Al HaMechia, the Bach writes that the earthly land of Israel draws its holiness from the supernal land of Israel, the divine influence of which then flows into the fruit of the land. Thus, by eating the fruit, we draw holiness into ourselves. However, when the land has been polluted by the Jewish people and they have been exiled, the source of the land's fruit is now tum'ah, spiritual impurity, and by eating the fruits now, we internalize this tum'ah. Based on other Kabbalistic teachings, Rav Teichtal takes this further, remarking that the land is described as Eretz Ochelet Yosheveh Hahi, a land that consumes its own inhabitants. The impurity that is now rampant throughout the land will lead to the deaths of those who try to settle it, as it is surrounded by Kalipot. Thus, Rav Teichtal in this newspaper rejected any possibility of moving to the land of Israel until God himself were to cleanse it of its impurity. The advent of Nazism and the horrors that accompanied it had a profound effect on Rav Teichtal. The Nazis invaded Czechoslovakia in 1938 and they began deportations in 1942, and Rav Teichtal, his family, and 10 other families hid in an attic above a Beit Midrash. Through cracks in the attic, he saw the brutal conduct of the Nazis beating the Jews and taking them away. These traumatic events prompted a paradigm shift in Rav Teichtal's outlook. He could not stop thinking that had the Jews been in the land of Israel, this would not have taken place. This is where he began his magnum opus, Im Habanim Semecha. Im Habanim Semecha represented a complete about-turn in Rav Teichtal's Hashkafah. He criticized the positions of the Orthodox establishment, his own position included, which prevented religious settlement of the land. It is clear that he who prepares prior to the Sabbath will eat on the Sabbath, and since the Haredim did not toil, they have absolutely no influence in the land. Those who toil and build have the influence, and they are the masters of the land. It is therefore no wonder that they are in control. Now, what will the Haredim say? I do not know if they will ever be able to justify themselves before the heavenly court for not participating in the movement to rebuild the land. As well as this, Rav Teichtal advanced arguments drawing on the entire gamut of Jewish literature, which he recalled mentally without access to his library, and relied heavily on Kabbalistic assertions as to the value of the land of Israel. He adopts a position similar to Rav Kook in ascribing equal value to secular Jews who are building up the land of Israel and Orthodox Jews who oppose Zionism. He writes that the builders of the land are God's messengers with foundations in the apex of sanctity. God forbid that we call our fellow Jews wicked, for they are all descendants of Hashem's loved ones. Rav Teichtal and his family were eventually caught and sent to Auschwitz. With the advance of the Soviet army, many prisoners were transported inwards towards Germany, and Rav Teichtal was killed on the train to Mauthausen concentration camp. Now, even in more recent times, it's quite awkward to have your dad known not only as a Zionist, but as a former Haredi who became Zionist. So when Im Habanim Semecha was re-released, his son added a foreword that said, "There is a great danger in reading this work superficially, seeking a modern-day ideology with which to associate its message. To reduce the sacred Torah principles laid forth on these pages to Zionism is a desecration, a blasphemy." Perhaps someone should have told him to read the book first.